Nothing.
Yeah. Who shall I send it to then?
I was brought up to believe that money was a subject you didn't talk about, that it was vulgar to talk about money.
Yes, a lot of us were raised the same way, and that's why a campaign like this hits a raw nerve in all working people.
35, 150, $150, $100.
And that's why Joan Weldon's sales force is so energetic and committed. They are other working people, adding up the checks and cash that are coming in response to the flyers they've been distributing and the articles they've written.
Joan is like a wonderful person. If it were you or me, she'd be at the front of the line. There's no question about it, helping. But this is something else good that Joan has done. It's because she's brought people together.
Until she got sick in December of 91, Joan was a longtime staff member at one of the city's top law firms. She's a paralegal with the firm of Blank, Rome, Comiskey, and McCauley. And even though she hasn't been well enough to work for a year, they still consider her part of their family.
As much as we've raised now, we really only have days to raise more. Joan's life depends on just days of collection.
It's just incredible. I mean, people's outpouring is wonderful, but we need more, and we need it quickly.
Everyone from support staff all the way up to top lawyers is behind the fundraising campaign. In fact, her boss is a top legal eagle in health matters. But even though he's an expert in wading through the fine print of contracts as confusing and disappointing as Joan and Bill Weldon's health plan with Blue Cross, he's more interested in helping with the fundraising project at the moment.
The issue right now is the time. The law may be sure, but sometimes it is not as fast as we would like. And the problem is we have to do this by December 1st. So that whatever happens in the long run in terms of the legal issues are not relevant today. The relevant is saving this woman's life.
Joan is the past president of the Paralegal Association of Philadelphia. And through her contacts there, the pitch for funds has been circulated throughout every big law firm in the city.
Here's some more money.
Okay, good.
And here's some additional flyers if you could pass them out.
Mary O'Donnell Green collects checks that come in through the door of the association and delivers them to Blank Rome and another paralegal who has a passionate interest in the success of the fundraiser. It's Joan's own brother, Mike Monchik, who is also a paralegal for Blank Rome.
Little checks, big checks, anything in between. But we would need a lot of these handfuls to come up with all the money that we need for her.
How's this feeling for you, her brother?
It's tough. I have my workload here at the office. I have a wife and two children at home. And, you know, I'm with Mary Green. I'm coordinating the fundraising effort on Joan's behalf. So, I mean, it's a lot of time, and it's very hectic all the time in the last 10 days, and just very nerve-wracking.
Meanwhile, back in Mayfair, each member of the household handles the stress of the campaign differently. Joan's younger daughter, Tracy Quinn, a student at Chestnut Hill College, is dedicated but honest about how it's changed the household.
It's not embarrassing. It's just you're not private anymore, really. You know, there's people always coming in the house, and I mean, we appreciate the help, but it's just we're kind of a private family.
Joan's older daughter, Kelly Quinn, a senior at Temple, is always holding back the tears.
I'm supposed to graduate from college in May, and it's really the only thing my mother ever wanted for me, and now there's a chance she might not even be there.
And Joan's husband, Bill Weldon, a retired Philadelphia cop, is on duty. There's no better way to describe his commitment to the fundraising, to his stepchildren, to his wife above all.
I do whatever I have to do. Lick envelopes, put stamps on, comfort my wife, lose sleep, get up early, go to work, come home, take her where she wants to go, and
start all over tomorrow.
Yep.
Even though it's weeks before Thanksgiving, Joan takes time away from the fundraising campaign to wrap Christmas presents. If all goes well, she'll be unable to touch paper and scotch tape during the month of December. She'll be isolated in this unit at Hahnemann Hospital, getting the bone marrow treatment that might save her life. And when you see the machines, the medical treatment, and the intensive care that this protocol requires, the dollars and cents of it becomes more understandable. Even if the reason for this campaign, the fact that an insured person can't get the treatment that their doctor recommends, even if that part is not so understandable.
The high-dose chemotherapy will work better on a smaller volume of tumor. So the smaller volume, the better. The longer we wait, the more likely there is to be a larger volume. At the point that I evaluated her, she had minimal tumor. I mean, she had evidence of cancer, both on blood tests and x-rays, but it was relatively small. And those are the kind of people we're looking for in our protocol to try this on, because those are the ones we think that it will work the best in.
Okay.